French President Emmanuel Macron visited a Jewish graveyard in eastern France Tuesday that had been vandalized just hours earlier, the latest in a series of such anti-Semitic attacks that are driving deep concern across the continent.
A group of hateful individuals committed what others sadly have committed in the past for too many years.
Thousands of people gathered in Paris and other French cities Tuesday evening, demanding an end to rising anti-Semitism. The demonstration was called in response to this incident Saturday, when a Jewish writer was targeted outside his Paris home by so-called yellow vest protesters, shouting "dirty Jew" and "bloody Zionist." It was the subject of a debate at the Munich Security Conference Sunday under the provocative title, "Should Jews Stay or Leave Europe?"
I believe that we are not on the peak of anti-Semitic movements in the world. We are perhaps even just starting.
Friedman traces a mainstream political acceptance of such views to Austria in the year 2000, when the extreme right leader Jörg Haider entered the governing coalition.
We thought at the time that this would be a moment of misunderstanding, one and never again. Today it is common. The AfD in Germany is elected. They want to rewrite history. They are clearly anti-Semitic and they are racist, but we have this in France with Le Pen, we have governments in Hungary, we have governments in Poland, we have governments in Italy. It's not only an East European problem.
Those parties deny they are anti-Semitic. It is to Eastern Europe that Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has looked to for international support. Critics say he has willingly overlooked growing anti-Semitism in the region, such as the vilification of US-based Jewish financier George Soros.
The fact that Israel is running friendly relationship between itself and countries in Eastern Europe should not undermine a clear message coming from Israel saying we do not accept that, even if these countries are friendly towards Israel.
Democrat Congressman Tom Malinowski says anti-Semitism is a growing problem in the United States.
Something is giving people with that mindset the feeling that they now have the permission to express their views.
Views being expressed through violence, vandalism and abuse that are forcing Jews to question their very future in Europe. Henry Ridgewell for VOA News, London.